Hello, I'm Armin. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll show you how to calculate the natural frequencies of a room. First, I will analyze the room without any absorptive materials, and then I will analyze it with absorptive materials in the sofa, floor, and ceiling. If you're interested in acoustics or want to learn how to use the impedance boundary condition, this video is for you. I'll explain everything step by step, making it easy to follow. Let's get started. In the first step, I'll select the model result. Since the room is 3D, I need to click on the 3D space option. I will perform an acoustic analysis and expand the acoustic section. There are several options, but we need pressure acoustics frequency domain. I'll click on that and hit add. Finally, I'll hit on steady to move on to the next step. I want to calculate natural frequency, so I'm gonna choose eigenfrequency and hit on done. I will start by creating the geometry. I downloaded it from the Comsol library, and now I want to import it. Right-click on Geometry 1, and select Import. Click on Browse, and select Geometry. Finally, click on Import. Geometry will appear in the graphics window. As you can see, the geometry consists of a room with a sofa, a TV, and a table. Now let's define the material for room. I'm going to right-click on Material and select Add Material from Library. In the built-in section, we can find air, select it and click Add to Component. Note that I am only assigning material properties to the surrounding air. I will define the impedance for the surfaces, so there's no need to assign materials to them. Everything looks good so far. For now, I won't be adding any absorptive materials, so I'll stick with the default settings and move on to the mesh. The element size is a function of frequency, but in the eigenfrequency study, we don't have a defined frequency. If I click Build All now, we'll encounter an error. What should we do? We need to define the maximum frequency in the setting window. Here, we need to switch from steady to frequency. Since the natural frequency of the room is low, I think 300 Hz will be enough. Now, we can click Build All and see the mesh. Everything looks correct, so we can proceed to solve the model. I'm going to click on Step 1, Eigenfrequency from the Model Builder Tree. Here, we can see the frequency. It's important to specify the correct frequency. Since the natural frequency of the room is low, it's better to choose a low frequency, for example, 40 Hz. After solving, if the first natural frequency is not close to zero, you'll need to reduce the frequency. Let's solve it and check the results. The solution is complete, and now we can see the natural frequencies. The first natural frequency is close to zero, and the second one is the lowest non-zero value, which is considered the fundamental frequency. This means we specified the values correctly. We'll view the mode shapes by clicking the Plot Next arrow. All natural frequencies are real values because the walls are rigid. Now, let's define the absorption properties for the sofa, table, and walls. Let's add impedance for the absorptive surfaces. I'll navigate to the Physics tab, expand Boundaries, and find impedance. First, let's select the sofa surface. Okay, everything looks correct. Change the impedance model from user defined to absorption coefficient. I think a value of 0.02 is sufficient for the sofa. Now, I want to add another absorption coefficient for the floor. I'll choose impedance again from boundaries and click on the floor. Change the impedance type to absorption coefficient, but leave the value unchanged. Now, I'll move on to the ceiling to define an absorber for it. We can also select impedance again and switch from user defined to porous layer. the boundary conditions and values were chosen solely for learning purposes. For example, we have a porous material on the ceiling. Let's define a 2 cm thickness for the porous layer and change the fluid material to air. We need flow resistivity, and there's a red cross next to the material icon. Change the flow resistivity value from material to user defined. I think 8000 is a good value. The red cross beside the material has disappeared now. Okay, everything looks correct now. We can solve it again. The solution is complete, and now we can see the room's frequencies. All frequencies are complex numbers because there are several absorptive objects in the room. In the eigenfrequencies evaluation group, we can see the angular frequency, quality factor, and damping ratio in a table. Now, I want to see the natural frequency without any absorption, like in the previous solution. I'll navigate to Study tab and hit on Add Study. Add Eigenfrequency Solver. Change the frequency from 100 to 40 Hz. In the Physics and Variables section, we need to disable the impedances since I want the solution without any absorption. Let's double-check the studies. This is 40 Hz, just like in Study 2. Everything looks correct now. We can click on Compute and wait for the solution. The solution is complete. Now we can see all the frequencies, which are real values because there are no absorptive materials. As an illustration, let's examine the fifth natural frequency. We can also view the sound pressure levels and the isopharses of each mode shape. This concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you found it helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel.